Let's go ahead and start with a song, and then we'll talk for a little bit.
Okay.
Cool.
All right, we're going to start with a song called Don't Break the Needle. I've been the sick leg for a seven time in red. Elevator tries up your martyr in bed. And you're sitting on a gold mine, shooting up the old time, cleaning up the refuse of your black shirt and coke line. Now I've been pulling thread, doing all kinds of evil. No, you hate me, baby, but don't break the needle. Hey, 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 how, how? Me lay up and me crawl.
And the Business performing for us live in our Big Room Studios, playing tonight a sold-out show here in Columbus, City 1025, Day Side A. Thanks to you, I guess, so much for being here.
Thank you, guys. Yeah, we're
absolutely.
We're kind of, working our way up through that whole pavilion. I feel like we started playing to like 10 people in the downstairs bar. Then we played to 15 people the next time, so that was nice.
And now to so many more. Well, I got to say, this is like one of the most packed out big rooms I think we've had. So
nice.
Columbus definitely loves you guys. Now, I think that this is a big question on everyone's mind, and I say this with no, I guess, pressure intended, but are we going to get some new music soon from you guys?
No.
There you go, right there.
We're writing and working and kind of took a break. I had a kid. They didn't
Congratulations.
Have kids.
Yeah. That's huge.
Yeah, so it's been a nice break. We basically did not take a break from the road for like 10 years. So it was kind of like tour, make a record. And this is the first time that it's kind of been like, let's pump the brakes for a second. And I mean, we've been writing, but I don't know when something new will be out, but we're hoping fall-ish. Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, absolutely. Like I said, no pressure. But I heard that you also built a home recording studio.
Yeah, well, it's not my home, but yeah, we kind of took over this insane, it actually used to be a grenade factory. It was a grenade factory in World War I, and then I don't know what was, after that, I think people just threw garbage in there for like 30 years, because it took like a week and a half for us to clean it out, and then 3 months to like take on a way bigger project probably than we ever should have, but basically Logan and I spent the coldest winter on like record in Richmond in a not heated warehouse, like building out this whole studio, and the beards were long and hands were cold for sure.
Looking a little grizzly.
Yeah.
No, I like it. Well, cool. Let's go ahead and do another song here in the big room. What song are you going to play next for us?
I think we're doing Hard Times. Yeah, this one's called Hard Times.
Nice. Give it up, J. Roddy Walston and The Business.
Good times will come, the good times will roll away. You can get a good time, the good time ain't gonna stay. So I'm gonna come to you, I'm gonna come with you. Yeah, you're a hard time, but you're the kind that's long and true. Yeah, come a time, I'm gonna come to you.
Making good time, making good time, making good time. Down the road, down the road. And then the bad times will come, yeah, the bad times will come, yeah, the bad times will come.
Darling, my hard time, hey, my hard time is slow.
Women wanna live, leave a man who wanna die. Woman knows better, but the young man he gotta try. So I'm gonna come to you, I'm gonna come to you.
Making good time, making good time.
Down the road, down the road.
And then the bad times will come, yeah, the bad times will come, yeah, the bad times will come.
Darling, my hard time, hey, my hard time is sweet,
is sweet.
Side A of City 1025 Day out at Express Live on the indoor stage. We'll see you down there if you got your tickets. Like I said, it's sold out. Now, I'm glad that you guys are back out on the road. I saw that you're doing quite a few festivals this summer, including you're actually going to come back to Columbus and play the inaugural Promo West Fest.
Yeah.
Which is cool.
That should be cool.
Yeah.
I hope it's cool.
It will be.
We're going to try to be a part of it being
Man,
cool.
Man, if you guys are here, it's definitely going to be cool. I know that it's a really diverse, fun lineup with Lock the Moon and brand new Snoop Dogg. I guess, was there ever a point in your life when you thought, huh, I'm going to share a stage with Snoop Dogg someday?
So far, the high point of our hip-hop collaboration has been sharing a stage with Afro Man.
Oh, my God.
And that was amazing.
I bet it was amazing.
He pulled up in a minivan that was full of smoke. Rolled down the window and wouldn't get out to the guy handing him a wad of cash.
You're kidding.
Not a joke.
So
we adopted that practice immediately.
That's what I was going to say. I hope that you put that into practice. Yeah. Leslie, do you have the money for them after the big room? Okay, cool. Good to know. That's awesome. You're also going to do Bunbury down in Cincinnati as well, so make sure that you get your tickets for that, as these guys are awesome. Now, I saw that you played the Rock and Roll Hotel as well in D.C.
Yeah.
How was that?
The rooms are great there.
Well, that's what I was wondering. It's a place called the Rock and Roll Hotel with a venue. Do you stay in the hotel that night after the show?
It's not an actual hotel.
Oh, it's not.
No.
Oh,
but we like to call and pretend that we're trying to make reservations there.
Stop it.
Yeah. We were on a tour and we got a hold of the promoter's number and we started calling him late at night. It was when we were out with Lumineers. We played at like 6 p.m. and then we had the rest of eternity to just come up with stupid things to do. So we started calling the promoter from the Rock and Roll Hotel at like 2 in the morning, and he would be like, "This is Steve Piercy from Rat. We're just so tired and we've heard good things about your hotel." And then we were like, "Oh, what if he calls you back? He's going to know it's you." So he changed his voice message for a while that just said, "Steve Piercy, Rat."
Stop. That's amazing. And I love that you just said that you forgot about that. Like, stuff like this just happens, and you can forget that something like that happened. You guys are pranksters. Yeah. A lot of time in the van. Well, that's awesome. Well, again, very, very happy to have you back out here on the road and playing for us in Columbus. Make sure that, you know, you rock out with these guys tonight. You guys bring such amazing energy to the stage, and I think that it's just what Columbus wants and needs. So, it's
right
cool.
Now, I'm not even on the stage.
Technically, you're not. You're right. You're right next to me. I like it. Well, let's do another song here in the big room. What song are you going to play for us this time?
I think this is our last song for right now, but this is called "Take It As It Comes."
Cool.
Yeah. come.